Hello again, Yu-Gi-Oh! Fans, this is Jeff of the Game Capital. Got 8 packs of Speed Duel here. I'm in an event for this. We'll be making a deck, 23 card deck, out of these 8 packs. Maybe I'll show you what the deck ends up being. I'll have to be a different video or not, but let's get open here and see what we've got so we can get our deck built. So we've got Whiptail Crow, Queen's Knight, Zombie Tiger, and Wicked Breaking Flemburg Bao. I don't know, you know how I am with these pronunciations sometimes. Always lots of fun. Always lots of fun. And obviously there will be background noise as this is a tournament. There's one super rare. That's one card I've not seen pulled very often so far. Queen's Knight, Zombie Tiger. This seems familiar. Wicked Breaking and Conscription. Almost identical packs there for the first two. Three of the four cards the same. Not necessarily a bad thing. Now if we get some other knights, that'd be amazing, but Half Shut, that's a good one to get. Armored Zombie, Shield and Sword, and King of the Skull Servants. If we don't get any Skull Servants, that's kind of a moot point, but we'll go ahead and stick that in a sleeve right away, but probably not the best super to get, especially in a sealed format like this. So if we don't get, well, we probably want at least three Skull Servants, but yeah. Decayed Commander, Dragon Zombie, Mystic Horseman, and Desert Twister Ultra Rare. Got that in our box opening previously as well, as the kin as well, but still not too bad. I mean, it's a one tribute for 2300 attack, and there's the ability if you're not familiar. It cannot be normal summoner set though, so by banishing two wind and one earth monsters from your graveyard. So, we'll have to see how it all plays out, but not sure how viable that will be. This will obviously be a shorter video because it's not very long to open 8 of these. Harpy's Pet Dragon, nice. Magician's Unite. There's one Skull Servant. And White Elephant's Gift. Let's see. Three more packs. Hope we can get one more foil. Wasteland. Magical Ghost. Great Mammoth of Gold Fine. I don't think we got either of those yet though. So, oh yeah, and there's no polymerization in this set, so good luck with that. Block attack. Oh, he got the Call of the Haunted. The ultra rare skill. One of them. Dispel. Jax Knight. Limit Impulse. And Violet Crystal. And last pack, Last Chance for Glory. We get one more foil. We get one more. We've got Buster Blader. Common Charity, nice. Possessed Dark Soul. Clown Zombie. It's nothing too awesome. We'll see what we can put together. I'll probably have PCs together, so I'll probably be back in a moment with the actual deck. Alright, so the tournament has now concluded. This is being recorded a couple days later. But anyways, I end up going in a 14-person event with 14 players. I went 3-1, and I got second place, my only loss being to the one undefeated in the third round. So for second place, everyone in top 8 ended up getting a Destiny draw, a skill card in ultra rare form. The winner that went undefeated got a very cool playmat featuring Bones on it, which looked really cool. I think it has King of the Skull Servants on the playmat art as well. Since I didn't pull a skill card, I and many others got to use this straight to the grave. It's actually in the set as a super rare, I believe. So all dinosaur, zombie, and rock monsters on the field gain 200 attack defense. And actually, my first 3 of the 4 rounds, myself and my opponent each had a skill card. So they then stack, I guess. So all dinosaurs and zombies and rock monsters got plus 400 attack and defense, which makes for some pretty beefy zombies in particular. My sideboard's pretty irrelevant, just because I felt that I should have 5 anyway. Harpy's Pet Dragon, Skull Servant, which I only pulled 1 of. King of Skull Servants, also pulled 1 of. And then what I should have had in my main deck was 2 Wicked Breaking Flamberg Bows. I think I read the card wrong, thinking it like negatively impacted me in some way or something, or that I like attach it to my opponent to give them 500 attack, but they lose their skill, or I don't know. I read the card very wrong, so I sideboarded it, and I should have had the main deck. I don't think it would have made a difference in the game I lost. They're all best of 3. All 3 rounds that I won 2-1, and the one round I lost 2-0. So I was 6-5 overall on a per game basis. But anyways, the actual main deck I ran, play as many zombies as I could. This is not a zombie, but Possessed Dark Soul. That's a card that primarily made me lose the one round I lost. My opponent uses, I think, both games to steal two of my monsters, leaving me with nothing, and could not come back from such things. So you can tribute this monster, face-up card, take control of all face-up level 3 or lower monsters your opponent currently controls. And you'll see how many level 3s I have here in a second. So we got Decay Commander. I got one of that and two Zombie Tigers. Decay Commander, when this card is normal summoned, you can special summon the Zombie Tiger to from your hand. And then if this card inflicts battle damage to your opponent by a direct attack, you discard a random card from their hand. Zombie Tiger, it's a vanilla 1400, 1600 if it's not unioned with Decay Commander. Otherwise, it's equipped to it. It adds 500 attack and defense to Decay Commander, making it a 1500, 2000 before the straight to the grave effects and such as well. And if the equipped monster destroys an opponent's monster at battle, then discard a random card from the hand. So if you've got them together, then whether you attack them directly or you attack and destroy a monster, you can make your opponent discard a card. So I got one and two. And the person that got third in the tournament, I think, had two of each of these, which would be a lot better, but still one and two, not too shabby. We got one armored zombie, 1500 attack. Again, being a zombie, it was a 1700, usually a 1900. Clown zombie, 1350 base, 2-star. Armored zombie is a 3-star. The zombie tigers are 3-stars. Dragon zombie, 1600 attack, 3-star. Magical ghost zombie that has 4 stars, but only 1300 attack, but actually has some defense. So that's all my zombies. So in my deck, I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 zombies that got the attack and defense boosts. I had Buster Blader in there, never actually saw the field though. One Jacksknight, also never saw the field. Jacksknight's one I possibly would have dropped for the Wicked Breaking Flamberg Bows. A couple of Queen's Knights, 1500, 1600. So good, strong numbers for a 4-star in the sealed format. Again, for this event, you open 6 packs of the Speed Duel Booster Packs and then made your deck from just those 8 packs, plus the skill card, which isn't part of the 20 to 30 card deck, plus 5-card sideboard. Whiptail Crow, 1650 attack. I think that's the strongest non-tribute monster before any added abilities from Straight to the Grave. One block attack. I think I actually used that once or twice. Dispel, use that a bit. Half Shut, would have loved to have had two of that card in the deck at least, but only pulled the one. Shield and Sword I used for a nice little combo move at one point in particular. Violet Crystal gives you a 300 attack defense to a zombie. Wasteland, another possible option to drop just because it's the same as Straight to the Grave basically. So nobody ever dispelled my Straight to the Grave, so I never needed to play Wasteland. So it's basically a dead spot in the deck, but still. White Elven's Gift, I probably would have definitely dropped for the Wicked Breaking Flamberg Bow. I don't think I ever used this card. You would send a face-up non-effect monster you control to the graveyard to draw 2 cards. And my only 2 traps, Common Charity, draw 2 cards, and then banish a normal monster from your hand. You can't discard your entire hand. And then Conscription, which I used twice in the tournament and failed both times. I had one opponent round 4 use against me, and they also failed, so within my matches, this card was 0 for 3 and actually doing what you want to do. But I only used it in time situations. I played it like face down a few times and never actually activated it because it wasn't advantageous. Like if my opponent had like 1 card in hand and no monster in the field, like I was going to give him extra card draw even if I knew I'd get a monster, I'd obviously activate it. But the risk reward wasn't there most of the time. But when it was, I activated and I still did not get the desired outcome. But again, in the end, round 1 and round 2, I went 2-1. Round 3, 0-2. Round 4, 2-1. Again, my only loss was to the only undefeated. So I actually ended up in second place thanks to tiebreakers. So that's how my deck looks. If you want to see more deck profiles of constructed stuff, let me know in the comments below if it's something you're looking to do. And if you're looking for singles for Speed Duel or regular Yu-Gi-Oh! As well, we will be expanding that stuff on our website very, very soon, thegamecapital.com. So stay tuned for more Speed Duel content here from us, most likely, and more products available on our site as well. Otherwise, please subscribe, rock, smash the like button. Again, visit thegamecapital.com, and we'll hopefully have a lot more awesome content for you very soon, between Yu-Gi-Oh! And Pokemon and Magic, Karma Vanguard, all that good stuff. Again, PokePack Daily is airing on the Poke Capital channel again, 6 a.m. Eastern every day, and I should be bringing back Beyblade videos pretty soon to the Beyblades 24/7 channel. Just gotta find the time on my schedule to get that added to my repertoire. So, yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time, wherever and whenever that may be.